David Barr, Muscle and Fitness, NSCA 2009. Here with Kurt Davidson, President of Exerbotics. You may have seen this in the URSA article, the URSA Online. This stuff is very cool, cutting-edge equipment. Kurt, can you tell us more about it?
Absolutely. This is the first computer-controlled strength equipment ever built. Basically, there are no weights, no pneumatics. Everything is done by robotic electric motors and computers. It primarily does some amazing things. One, it overcomes all the inefficiencies of weight training. There's no sticking points. It allows maximum muscle improvement throughout the entire range of motion, providing a really superior effective workout.
Excellent. All right, I'm going to try a few reps and let's see how it goes.
We've already set David's range of motion up here, so we'll go ahead and start the machine. It'll come back and rest for about 3 seconds, and then David can get in. The machine automatically adjusts to David's own biomechanics and strength levels. It's fun to watch on this side. He's getting immediate feedback on the screen. One thing very noticeable is he's getting negative lifts on the eccentric side, which just automatically happens because it conforms with the body's capability. David, you act like you're feeling that.
A little bit, yeah.
You have to breathe a little more often than this, but you're in constant tension.
So actually, if you want to leave it, this is what's happening. I'm just pressing against this. It's moving by itself. So I can press as hard as I want, both positive and negative part movement. It's going to move completely on its own. And this is actually what I was trying to replicate with iron in the Train for Pain article, which is in the August issue of Muscle and Fitness. So thanks very much, and we're going to take a look at the screen right now. So this is the heads-up display for the Exerbotics seated bench press. And you're seeing it just before I perform my first concentric or positive rep on the bench press. So essentially the bar is at my chest and I'm going to be pressing it away as hard as I can. Now let's take a second look at that, and you'll see a yellow line being produced. And this is happening in real time as I'm performing the rep, and it represents the force output, or essentially how hard I'm pressing against the bar. Now let's take a close-up view and see why this is important. Looking at the yellow line, the higher the line, the greater the force output or strength at any given second of the concentric rep. You'll notice that it's not flat, which represents our natural strength curve on the bench press. You're weaker at the beginning, when the bar is close to your chest, and at the end, which is full lockout. The middle of the rep is when you're strongest, and Exerbotics is one way to help train that portion of the movement. Now let's take a look at the eccentric or negative portion of the rep. So you just saw the real-time force output curve for the negative portion of the rep, and we're now looking at the close-up. The peak is much higher than on the positive portion of the rep, meaning that the strength or force output is greater, just as you'd expect. But what's amazing is just how much higher it really is. In this example, the peak concentric force was around 220 pounds, while the peak negative was 275. Now think about how much of the strength you're not using when you train with traditional weights, and think of the potential benefits if you could maximally train each portion of the rep. As mentioned earlier, I tried to replicate this with traditional weights using unilateral movements and forced eccentrics, discussed in the Train for Pain article, August 2009, Muscle and Fitness. To really drive this point home, take a look at the circled portion in the middle of the screen. This represents the lowest level of strength throughout the entire range of motion. This point is of tremendous significance because it is the highest amount of weight that you can train with if you want to do full reps. If the weight is heavier than this, you will fail to move the weight as soon as you hit this portion of the rep. In other words, this is going to be your sticking point. And once again, when you train with traditional weights, even if they feel maximal, you're still missing out on training your strength throughout the entire range of motion. Now, as you can imagine, this has implications for both muscle growth as well as strength. Now, as a final tip, you can get around this by occasionally using partials like board and floor presses, as well as lockouts in which you use only the very end of the concentric rep. Stay tuned to Muscle and Fitness for more ways of maximizing your size and strength. Until next time, raise the bar.